This is the moment you are waiting for. The goodness of the Lord will enrich you tonight. Can I hear you now in one accord? As you round up your prayers, you say, Amen. As you round up your prayers, can I hear you say, Amen. With one voice, can I hear you say, Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to say that amen until heaven hears you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Are you sure he comes? I'm asking you, who wants to experience him this night? Even if you are sleeping here now, you are going to experience him. Wave your hand unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, I thank you. Amen. Do you know why you are thanking him? Because you are the person the Lord is looking unto this night. He wants to know what he will do for you. Is there anything you want the Lord to do for you? If there is nothing you want him to do for you, I want you to know that the youths are the people that will take over this world. And then you are here this night. Tell the Lord, make me to take over. Amen. Amen. The reason for bringing you here is that we should hold the hands of Moses. Servant of God will not go to everywhere to minister the gospel while we sleep in our houses. Let me, you, be the hand of Jesus extended. Wonderful. So that anywhere you pass, the people will get a touch of the Lord. It means that anywhere you pass, the dying person shall live again. Shout hallelujah. And I know that you are ready to receive the Lord this evening. Can you wave your hand to the Lord again? I am seeing some precious hands that will be blessed this night. You see, watch it right now that the Lord is going to select you and make you somebody. Amen. The day that David was selected, his father kept him aside from the group of people that would be selected. He kept him in the bush and said, this one is not good for anything. And Samuel made a choice, but God said, not your choice, my own choice. And then Samuel started counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and they were finished. Nobody was chosen. And then he said, Jesse, no child of yours remained? He said, no one. Well, just small one in the bush. And then Samuel said, we are not going to sit down. Bring him. That's the precious one before the Lord. For man's rejection is God's selection. That is wonderful. No matter how far you have gone in life, put a full stop there, turn back and follow the Lord. This night you will see how the Lord is going to function in your lives. You are saying amen. Can you lift your hands up? I'm seeing seven persons this way now. Seven this way, seven this way, seven this way, that the Lord is selecting. Wave your hand right now. Or shall go round right now. See the way God is going to touch this wonderful youth. One by one now. I said seven gear, seven gear, seven gear, seven gear, seven gear. Usher, where are the usher? Okay, they're waiting for me to pray. No, that is not true. Go round. I said, God is here, the bridegroom cometh. And we are not telling stories. We are not telling stories. Let him go here quickly. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Watch them in group. Watch them right now. Go round, go round, go round, go round. Watch them right now as the Lord cometh. Watch them right now. Watch them. Watch them right now. Watch them, watch them, watch them. Bring them. I want to touch them. Watch them. Seven gear, seven gear, seven gear, seven gear. The Lord can make additions. Watch them right now. Go in, go in. Go in, go in, go in. Oh, watch that, those evangelists. Watch them in a group now. The Lord is going to select them. They will be great evangelists. Watch them now. Watch it there at the center. Watch them in a group. The Lord will select them. One, two, three, four, five. Oh yeah, bring them immediately. Check them out. Check them out. Check them out. The Lord is moving. The Lord is moving. I shall check them. Then I will take them one by one. One by one. Check them out. Check them out. You know what you will do? Bring them out so they don't match themselves. Bring them out so they don't match themselves. Watch out this evening. You will understand the meaning of the fact that the bridegroom cometh. He comes. It's not a fabrication. Bring them out before I will say any more thing. Bring them out. Bring them out. Bring them out. Holy Spirit is waiting for you. He wants to do great work in their midst. The Lord is changing you. That revival you are talking about, this is the moment of revival. This is the moment of knocking out everything that has been a hindrance. I shall go in, go in, go in. The Lord is selecting them. Go in, go in, go in. I shall go in. Everybody shout hallelujah. I shall watch this group of people as you are bringing them in. I mean bringing them out, bringing them out, bringing them out. You see, God will touch radical evangelists now. Radical evangelists right now. But do quick and bring them out. Because there will be wide movement now. Wide movement. There will be wide movement. Do quickly, bring them out, bring them out. Watch them, watch your lights. Or else you will go with some broken lamps. Watch your light, bring them out, check them. The Lord will be touching them this night. Yes, check them, check them, check them, check them, check them. Yes, check them, check them. Check five persons over there, five of them over there. Go there now, five persons right there at my right hand side. Watch them, one, two, three, four, five, over there. Watch, 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 go, 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 check them. Check them, five here again. Check them before I call the evangelists. God will anoint. Check them, check them, check them. Behold, the bridegroom cometh. By the power of anointing, every yoke must be broken. Your ministry will survive after this night. After this night of revival, check fast, check fast, check fast. Do quick, do quick. Do quick. Oh Lord. Maybe I have to stop to preach so that the ushers will get ready. Quickly. Check them, check them, check them. The power will be coming upon them. Their ministries will start manifesting. protect them. Lay your hands on your head. Don't bother raising it up. Check them before we call evangelists. If I call them, they will be too much for you. Check them now. Check them. If you are ready now, let me call evangelists for the touch of the Lord. If you are an evangelist, say thank you, Jesus. Usher, get ready. Get ready. If you know you have a calling as an evangelist, say thank you, Jesus. Usher, word them as they say it the third time now. Watch them all. That's why I say get ready. Get ready. We are here to begin. Evangelists, get ready for the anointing to do the work. Get ready. Are you ready? If you are ready, say amen. Usher, get ready now. For this amen you said now, Usher, get ready. Usher, if you are an evangelist, watch out now for your nation. Say thank you, Jesus. Every evil dream in the night, I cancel it in Jesus' name. Usher, go in. Evangelists are still waiting. Go in. Usher, you watch now. Five great evangelists, there will be a radical movement in the congregation now. Watch them right now. Five of them, as I count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Usher, you quickly go around. Watch them all. Some people will get a mad touch now. Evangelists, watch them. Don't drag them. Make sure you take care of them. Where are the usher? Say amen. Are you ready? Let us just praise God. Music ministers, are you ready? Okay, pick your microphone and help me while the Lord is still doing his work. Pick your microphone and help me. Let's just praise God. The Lord God of Watchman. Let's thank him and praise his name. Get ready. Are you ready, music ministers? No one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord, amen.
No one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord, amen.
No one like Jehovah, amen. No one like my God, amen.
No one like you, Lord, amen.
Oh, yes,
no one like you, Lord, amen.
Jesus, amen. No one like my God, amen.
Oh, no one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord, amen.
No one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord, amen.
There is no one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord, amen.
No one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you, Lord.
No one like you, Lord, amen. No one like you.
it unto your seats. Praise the Lord. Return to your seats. Don't worry, we are about to start. Help them to return to their seats. Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Amen!
Amen!
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord! Woo! We thank you because you are a merciful God. We thank you because you have called us together. It's not by accident. Lord, this is Watchman. And I praise your name for this night. Lord, we welcome you. Move in your great power and choose unto yourself men, young girls, young men, that we work for you in this our generation in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you have answered in Jesus' name. And amen. Have your seats. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Open your Bible to the book of Isaiah. Please, pastors, take note and send some people in the congregation. Isaiah chapter 49. Once you are there, you say amen. Amen. Isaiah 49 verse 24. First, shall the prey be taken from the mighty? Or the lawful captive delivered? I will not read further. We come back there. Did you hear me? I will come back there. Now, if you watch the question, I've been detailed to minister on this. And normally, I minister briefly. But I've been told not to be in a haste. And I see that there is a need. Last Monday, I remembered vividly the prayer our daddy made the day he came to our parish in Okokomaiko. And I told them from the pulpit that the Lord has said revival has started. And you will never be left out. Now this place we read, if you just look into that point, you will see that it provides a situation of impossibility. Can the prey be taken from the mighty? All of you are students. When a little animal is captured by the bigger animal, the little animal is seen as the prey. Take for example, lion grabs the sheep, lion grabs any other little thing like antelope, and you know that when the lion attacks, it attacks at a very strategic part of the body. A place that when it holds you, you can make noise. And mostly at the throat, neck region. It pursues the animal. As it gets close, it dives underneath. If you are running very fast, it draws you back from the back. Maybe it holds this place and then you are weak. It goes under. And when it holds your throat, a little bite will make, even if it releases you, you may not, you know, survive it. Now, this is what we have read in the Bible is showing us such a thing. The big lion has grabbed the little antelope and is at the neck, and the pangs and claws are upon the antelope. And then the Lord looks and said, this prey, can it be taken away from this mighty? That's what the Lord is asking. Naturally, physically, it is no longer possible. If you are coming close a lion, you know that they can destroy and devour that animal and come after you. Have you watched the bear? I saw the bear, some hunters went to hunt. And then they didn't know that a bear was around. And then they pounced on one of them. And others, instead of shooting the bear directly, they were shooting into the air so that the bear will be scared away. If you shoot the bear and ordinarily wounds the bear, it will eat and drink the blood of that person is holding. And the Lord said, this mighty, mightier than lion and the bear, is holding a prey. Can the prey be taken away? And then if you read it, you see the possibility is there. It's not possible. Why is it not possible? Because it's in the hand of the mighty. And this mighty signifies that the fellow is a combatant person, that nobody has fought and defeated before. That's why he used that mighty to tell you the person he's talking about, that he's not just a warrior, but he's such a warrior that has been fighting of ages and nobody has been able to defeat him. And he said, how do you take the prey away from him? And he didn't stop there. He said, and the lawful captive be delivered. Showing that that prey that the mighty was holding or is holding is being held lawfully. Is being held legally. And therefore, it was not illegal. As to say the law of nature is against you. The law of the land is against you. It was a lawful something. It was a lawful movement. And therefore, the law is for that mighty. The law is standing by his side. Nature is standing by his side. Now ask a question. How do you deliver and take free? It's impossible in the affairs of men. Quite impossible. And the Lord wants us to know this night the manner of God he is. And he's a mighty God in the watchman. Let us see the Bible. Praise the Lord. So, as you are following, it's asking us a question. We will go to answer the question. I show you clearly from the Bible what is showing. Let's go to Genesis chapter 49. Don't mind me, it's night. If I do not count point 1, point 2, point 3, point 4, maybe to point 10, I hope you will bear with me. So far, you understand what I'm teaching this night. Genesis 49. We go to verse 8. Genesis chapter 49, verse 8. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thy enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee. Judah is a lion's whelp from the prey. My son, thou art gone up. He stooped down. He couched as a lion and as an old lion. Who shall rouse him up? The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come. And unto him shall the gathering of the people be. Let's stop there. Now, we are coming small. You have seen Judah being seen as a lion and a warrior, and the promises of God unto Judah, that Judah was going to produce kings in Israel. And that Judah will be the person through whom Savior of the whole world will come. And Shiloh, the place of worship. And unto the Lord only shall the gathering of his people be. Who is the Lord that will come through Judah? God has made a promise, a wonderful promise. And then Judah was expectant. He was looking unto the Lord. By the time the Lord finishes with his promises, he fulfills it with his hand, then who will be around? To praise the God for me, who on earth could imagine the manner of person and nation Judah will be. He was so happy at the blessing of his father. Now you have to note it in life, as we are moving into this journey, and we are going from this journey here on earth to heaven, you must know that the blessings of your father are very important and significant. Do you know that? I'm asking you. Do you know that? Even if it's biologically, your biological father, even if he's a drunkard, he's your father. Being a drunkard has not stopped him from being your father. He's still your father. Am I correct? Yes. And so now we are talking of this, our spiritual father. Now, this Judah had been blessed by his own father, and what his father said must surely come to pass because God respects the fathers. But there was a problem. The problem of the prey and the mighty. The problem of the lawful captive came in. What was the problem? After this promise that his father has told him on the Lord God of Jacob, he was not very sure of keeping that promise. He just decided to live his life anyhow because promise had been made. After all, this promise must be realized. My brethren, whatever promise the Lord has made unto you, you must follow it cautionably. If you do not follow it and you live your life anyhow, you may not realize it eventually. If you repent later to go to realize it, you would have suffered untold hardship. And then Judah was waiting, but he didn't know that an enemy was waiting along the line to see how he was going to walk according to the promise of God. And Judah made mistake. The blessing started. Money started coming. Good things started following him. And Judah needed to enjoy his money. You will understand. Let's go to the Bible. Genesis 38. Genesis chapter 38. Let's read from verse 11. Then said Judah to Tamar. Okay, maybe I read from where you will understand what has happened. From verse 7. And A, Judah's firstborn was wicked in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord slew him. And Judah said unto Onan, go in unto thy brother's wife, and marry her, and raise up seed to thy brother. And Onan knew that the seed should not be his. And it came to pass, when he went in unto his brother's wife, that he spilled it on the ground, lest that he should give seed to his brother. And the thing which he did displeased the Lord. Wherefore he slew him also. Then said Judah to Tamar, his daughter-in-law, remain a widow at thy father's house. Go to your father's house till Shelah, my son, be grown. For he said, lest peradventure he die also, as his brethren did. And Tamar went and dwelt in her father's house. Come to verse 13. And it was told Tamar, saying, behold, thy father-in-law goeth up to Timnath to shear his sheep. Wealth has started coming. Success has started coming. And she put her widow's garment off from her, that is the widow of the sons, and covered her with a veil, and wrapped herself, and sat in an open place, which is by the way to Timnath. For she saw that Shelah was grown, and she was not given unto him to wife. When Judah saw her, he thought her to be an harlot, because she had covered her face. And he turned unto her by the way, and said, go to, I pray thee, let me come in unto thee. For he knew not that she was his daughter-in-law. And she said, what wilt thou give me, that thou mayest come in unto me? And he said, I will send thee a kid from the flock. And he said, wilt thou give me a pledge, till thou send it? And he said, what pledge shall I give thee? And she said, thy signet, and thy bracelet, and thy staff that is in thy hand. And he gave it her, and came in unto her, and she conceived by him. And she arose and went away, and led her veil from her, and put on the garments of her widowhood. From verse 24. And it came to pass about 3 months after that it was told Judah, saying, Tamar, thy daughter-in-law, had played the harlot. And also, behold, she is with child by Adam. And Judah said, bring her forth, and let her be burnt. When she was brought forth, she sent to her father-in-law, saying, by the man, whose these are, am I with child? And she said, design, I pray thee, whose are these? The signet, and bracelet, and staff. And Judah acknowledged them, and said, she had been more righteous than I, because that I gave her not to Shelah, my son. And he knew her again no more. Look up. Praise the Lord. We are talking of, shall the prey be taken from the mighty and the lawful captive delivered? And I'm coming. I said the prey was in the hand or is in the hand of the mighty. And the mighty is a man of war who has never lost in battle. And nobody could challenge him. How do you take the prey away from him? And not only that he was a combatant warrior, also he was doing what he was doing lawfully, legally, not illegal. Things he was doing were legitimate. And you must know that God made this situation because of the people of Israel originally, their lifestyle, their conduct towards God. And God was not happy with them. And then he allowed them to be taken into captivity. Then I want you to get the clarity as I go into this thing. And he allowed them. The enemy took over them. All the nations that came against them were able to conquer them because of the immoral lives, terrible type of life they were living. So if God allowed it to happen, who will save them? If God made them to go into captivity, who will deliver them? Now look at this man called Judah who had all promises going for him. And he didn't care to take time when success was coming. And then at that time he went to shear his sheep. And when he went there, he started looking for a harlot to enjoy his wealth. Not minding that the wealth he made came from God. And so the harlot, this daughter-in-law who was married from Er to Onan, and then two of them died, she was to be given to Shelah, a little lad. But Judah was afraid and said, I won't give. Let go. Let this child grow. But he didn't mean to give this woman to Shelah. And then eventually the woman, the daughter-in-law, heard that Judah was going to share his sheep. Maybe she had known the manner of father-in-law she had. And she went to wait for him along the road. And then changed the widowhood something. And then put on another veil like a harlot and covered her face. And immediately her father-in-law, he was attracted. And the man said, I will send the gift to you. Any quantity, I have it. I'm a rich man. Just go in with me. And the woman was very wise. Now he said, give me those things you have. Your staff, your bracelet, your ring, that signet, so that when you bring the other one, I will exchange it. Because he was terribly lost in, he gave those things that he was not supposed to give. Eventually, the woman conceived by him. And when he heard the story, he said, bring him, let us burn him. Burn her, please. Bring her, she's supposed to die. And the woman said, in fact, I'm supposed to die by what I did, but I will not die alone. Pay attention. But I will not die alone. Can you tell me whose these things are? And the man saw it and said, wonderful. How come? That day, you went to share your sheep. And then he said, I'd be more dishonored than this woman. Please let her go. Now, listen. What about the promises that have been made upon him? It has to wait, number one, for him to pay all the penalties for what he did. It has to wait. Now, my brethren that are here, we have lawful captives and we have prayers that are here today. I've not gone to the hostels where you are living, but if care is not taken, and I know some of you have stolen many handsets in the hostel. Am I correct? Some of you have stolen people's money. You are not doing it ordinarily. Something went wrong somewhere. That is the reason why you have been coming to church and you have been hearing the promises of God all the while. Sometimes your parents that are Christians have been praying for you and say, my son, we are following God. My daughter, we are following God. You can never be useless. But every day you see the devil messing you up. Why? You have changed the direction of your movement and you are facing another area. That blessings and promises must wait until you return back. And that place you are facing, whatever reproach that is there, that is what you are going to get. Sometimes people will go on into conducting deliverance and you will not agree to tell them exactly what you have done. You will tell them the minor ones and you hide the main thing you have done, which is the problem that the devil is holding against you. And you remain a captive in the hand of the devil. Praise the Lord. I hope you will not be distracted by the rain. Is anybody listening to me? By the time I'm rounding up this message, anywhere you kept the handset, you throw it to this place. You are not returning back with it. You are not a criminal. It was a trial by the devil, but you are conquering this night. Can I hear your amen? Now, look at what happened to Judah. After that, he did what he did. If you will understand that in those days, God has said, I will make kings from you and the rest of them. But after this thing happened, there was trouble. Don't you see that the kingdom was divided after Solomon, giving one to Jeroboam and one to Rehoboam? And if you check it, there have been a division of the northern kingdom from the southern kingdom because of this unfaithfulness. They couldn't take absolute control according to the promise of God. Now, look at what happened to his progenitors. Let's go to Matthew 1. I round up so that you will understand what I'm saying. Are you there? Matthew chapter 1. Are you there? Start from verse 1. The book of the generations of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac begat Jacob. And Jacob begat who? Judas and his brethren. And Judas begat who? Phares and Zerah of Tamar. You see that? And Phares begat Eshron. And Eshron begat Aram. And Aram begat Aminadab. And Aminadab begat Nashon. Begat Nason. And Nason begat Salmon. And Salmon begat Boaz of Rechab. And Boaz begat Obed of Ruth. And Obed begat Jesse. And Jesse begat who? David, the king. And David, the king, begat who? Solomon, of her that had been the wife of Uriah. And Solomon begat Rehoboam. And Rehoboam begat who? Abiah. And Abiah begat Asa. Stop there. You can now see that David came from the generation of Judas. Am I correct? You can also see that Solomon also came from that generation. Am I correct? From that lineage. Now, what did the devil do? That thing that their father did in the secret, Satan started publishing it. And said, how can you receive the promises of God when you are into this mess? You know how many wives David married? 8 wives. Do you know that? As you are talking of this one, he will marry another one. You know that what David did, that even some unbelievers are still judging him till today. But it was that lineage that he followed. The lineage that made Judah to commit such terrible adultery with a daughter-in-law and had a child through her. David followed it and married 8 wives and took even Uriah's wife. And then when Uriah could not agree to go in, he sent soldiers to leave him in the war front so that he could be killed. And the man was killed. He took over the wife. And many people are saying, can God forgive this man? That was only a small thing. He had a son called Amnon and had a daughter called Tamar too. What happened? Amnon said, I am so sick. Tell my sister Amnon to cook food. And Amnon said, I'm so sick. Tell my sister Tamar to cook food and come to give me. Let me eat from her hand. That evil of their father was tracing its root. And then Tamar cooked the food and came in. And then he threw away the food and raped the sister. Still following the lineage. And the other brother said, what has happened? Absalom, no problem. And then, what did he do? First of all, he terminated that Amnon. But that did not stop. It was Absalom that in the broad daylight brought all the concubines of David in the broad daylight. It's the light we are watching. And they started entering them one by one. The spirit of immorality started tracing that lineage. Did he stop there? Solomon said, my father married only 8. That was in the old generation. My own is a new generation. And then he gave his father Gab. 700 plus 300. How many? So even if you dance David's own with 100, it didn't reach Solomon's own. Solomon married and married. He remains to use women to make rappers. It was following. When your father sent you to go and steal, what do? You break the door with your leg. That was what happened to Solomon. Do you know that whatever you are doing now is waiting for your children? Am I correct? Now, what am I saying? You must ask about anywhere you are. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty and the lawful captive delivered? Any place you are, any church you are putting your leg, you must ask question, who is the father of this church? Is anybody listening to me? Look, if you enter any church that have erroneous foundation, the spirit in that church will follow you. True or false? If you check the churches in Nigeria today, I am not mentioning anyone, but you know, there are some quarters where pastors don't pray again. Once they know the native daughter that can give them ring, they get there immediately. And if that pastor is the general overseer of that church, everybody in that church must be terribly possessed. You run to that church and say, the other day I went, I saw what was happening there. In fact, I like this church, and you don't know where you are. Have you asked about the man of God? I ministered somewhere in a church where the general overseer uses the wife as a football. Any day he's angry, he will beat and beat and beat hell out of the wife. What did the wife do? My husband is like, you are immoral and you are general overseer of a church. And it's not like you are immoral. The man was terribly immoral. And the wife was complaining, but he will keep banging on the wife. And I discovered from the choir to the congregation, if you are looking even at the married women there, they will be inviting you in the church. It's the spirit of their father. Shall the prey be taken? These people in the church that are under this terrible yoke. Prey means that somebody plunged you also into this trouble. You don't know about it. And so you were captured for what you didn't do. Shall the prey be taken? And then because of that man, that your general overseer, you are suffering. Now you become a lawful captive because you get into sin by yourself. The general overseer now teaches you, you can get something. So when you raise your hand, people will be falling. You become a lawful captive. But he's saying, can the prey be taken and the lawful captive be delivered? It's left for you and me to answer. God has given us an answer. I will show you the answer of God. My young girls, there are some of us here that have delivered little children and we throw them into the toilet. And somebody is telling you that it doesn't matter. I tell you that record is fresh before God. If we are going to heaven, we must follow the way that Jesus followed. Let me tell you, I was not born again in Watchman. I've been saying, the other time I came, I told you that. And the general overseer of the church is real man of God. He has told me, you are the Esther of this church. But it was one message that I had, 1994. That message didn't allow me to sleep. It's still in my wardrobe till now, but it doesn't talk again. The message was on Sodom and Gomorrah. And I asked, who is the man that preached this message? I want to see him. Because when I heard the message, I know, or God ministered to me, or my spirit ministered to me, anyone you take, that is where you belong. That was how I came to Watchman. I've never had Watchman in my ear. And I came in, and I saw that this is where you can stay and go to heaven. Look, the way to heaven is not the way of pepper soup. If you watch out right now, praise the Lord. My beloved youth, praise the Lord. Are we happy this night? After this program, you will tell somebody I went to somewhere. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, if you watch our young girls now, their academic intelligence is how brief their skills are. In those days, it is when you pass well, you know you are somebody. But right now, you see small girls wear skills as mini or macro to this level, and they go to enter Okada. Check what the people tell you, your friends tell you, the type of dreams they see. We are propagating devil in all these things we are doing. And then he's bringing terrible dreams. And some old women that have formed churches because the spirit of Babalawo entered them and they said they are seeing road now. Nakedness everywhere. At the tender age of 16, how can a girl know a man to the point of throwing a child into the toilet? In fact, this particular person I'm talking about, you must see your leader this night. Don't go to bed without seeing him. You born a newborn baby. You even delivered yourself and threw the baby away. Shall the prey be taken away? Let's answer it in the Bible. My friend, tell your neighbor, say, there is hope in the Lord. I have great expectation that all of us that are here tonight can become mighty missionaries and evangelists. Yeah. Do you believe that? Yeah. Stand where somebody can see you make mistake and you are corrected. Don't get away. Let me show you the Bible. We are not playing church. Church is not football. Isaiah 49. They told me to take time. Abby? Sir, you should take time. Praise the Lord. Isaiah 49 from verse 24. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty or the lawful captive delivered? But thus say the Lord. Oh, read with me. Even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. For I will contend with him that contended with thee, and I will save thy children. Say amen. Wonderful. Can you say congratulations to your neighbor? The Lord has made a promise that this night, if you, no matter the problem you have, I don't have time to go into the Bible. If you get to 1 Kings chapter 13, you will see the problem of the old prophet and the problem of the young prophet. Old prophet means any backslider. Somebody that would have been burning, and then you are preaching and going up and down. I have listened. You see what happened to Judah. Success came and he failed. There is always a danger point. Anytime you see yourself doing well, is anybody listening to me? When you fail, you will decide to hustle to make sure you pass. But immediately success comes, it goes to the brain. Success is more dangerous than failure. If you are asking God for success even this night, you must tell God to humble you. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, God said, both the prayer and the lawful captive, all of them will be snatched from the mighty. What is he going to do? How is he going to do? He said, I will contend with him that do what? That contended with you. Praise the Lord. Every law comes from the word of God. Nigerian type of law, we say that it is adversarial, that is contentious. Where you come, all your target is how to bring down your enemy. The person before you, the plaintiff, that's Clement, and then the defendant. You try everything possible to show that this person should go to cell. He must pay for damages. And so the other person is trying every way around to make sure that you pay for it, that you go in. We call it adversarial. You call it contentious or censorial type of law court. Now, that is what God is saying. He said he will enter into pleading with the devil. And then devil will say, you killed, you destroyed, you told lies. Look at what you did. And God will ask him, now, what about you? How holy are you that are judging them? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now, we have come before the Lord, and God is our judge. We are going to tell him the truth. Will we tell him the truth? Yes. Tell him what you have done. Tell him how you have done it.
In fact, the ones you will not take him is the handset you stole in the dormitory now. You are going to bring that one out. Nobody will kill you. After all, our daddy is around. Nobody will even look at you. I will not look at you. You can't go with it. If you come to my parish, you will see all manners of handsets and bags. People want to bring the guns they were using to go into robbery. And I came to the head office to seek the advice of our daddy, but I was not permitted to take the guns from them. And from that year till today, they are still worshiping God. God has forgiven them. This night is your own night. Will you be delivered? Will the prayer and will the lawful captive be delivered? Do you know that some of the problem of rebellion we have in the church is a generational problem? Am I correct? Your father and his younger brother have been fighting since they were born. And you grew up and you grew into that fighting. And now you say you are born again, you get into the church. The next person to you say, let's fight like my father and his brother. Some people that came from polygamous families, check it. But the Lord is interested in delivering each and every one of us. Don't ever say this night, I've been trying to stop homosexual, but this thing, I can't stop it. Most every time the thing will come upon me like alcohol. It's a spirit. That spirit will leave you this night. Spirit of lesbianism will leave you this night. In the name of Jesus. Some of us that read and read and read, and you feel you have been able to pick up what you are reading, immediately you could close your book, basket brain, everything will sieve out. The Lord will do you good this night. In every area the devil has been pursuing you, take it this night, you must be delivered. You are afraid of death. Every time your mind is ministering to you, you are going to die. That is a contrary spirit. Maybe what is happening in your family, you are saying, I just have to die like others. And you are coming to church, but you are still afraid. One day, they will say that I've died because of what is happening in your family. But every yoke must be broken. I know a particular man, or my daddy told me, and they showed us, if not here, I've told you somewhere, a particular land, people were dragging over the land. And then we, the children, were asking, who actually was the owner of the land? They said, none of the people that were dragging for it. And then we said, where was the owner? They said, he has no person left behind. Everybody in that family has perished. And then we asked, what happened? He said, in those traditional tribal war, that the man went with a group, a team of, you know, traditional soldiers to go and fight in a town. And a particular woman saw them coming and took her child and put in an elevated place and ran away. And then the child didn't know anything. Their leader came there and then drew out his sword from my village to kill the child. The child thought that the man was playing with him and started laughing. I think I told you that in Akure. And was laughing. And the man withdrew his sword. He couldn't kill this child. The second person said, what's that? Come out. And then wanted to strike the child. The child burst into laughter. And that one, you know, he picked back his sword and put it in the sheath. And then this particular man came out and said, what are you people doing? Drew his sword. The child laughed like never before. And then he smashed the child. And the child died. And then he went. But God saw it and traced him to his house. He had even two wives. And they had the children. All of them perished. Nobody remained. Whosoever shed the blood of men, by the hand of men will his own blood be shed. If you have word abortion, don't take this message under the curtain. If you have confessed it and God has forgiven you, not in the corner. If you have seen your pastor, no problem. But if you are the person that threw away a living child, you didn't even kill the child, you just threw the child away. You must see your leader this night. And for sure, the Lord will forgive you. Shall the prayer be taken away from the mighty? No matter how strong the enemy may be, God, can you compare the power of God with that of devil? Has he any hope again? The devil has no hope, but we have great expectation in the Lord. And all of us that are here, he will not just forgive you from this night, your joy will abound. Can you imagine the love that made God to send Jesus Christ for our sake? After making the promise, and as he died on the cross of Calvary, he rose up and came to us and said, all power in heaven and earth have been given unto me. How was he given unto you? I went down by the thing that devil thought that he had finished human race. He said, I have killed the King of glory, but that was my opportunity to meet him down there in hell. He went to hell and knocked on his door. He opened the door. He said, who is that? He said, that's the Lord mighty in battle. You had thought you are a mighty man, but I'm the one mighty in battle. Huh? Is he not the one I killed? How come that you are saying Jesus was banging? Open the door. Who is that? The Lord of hosts. I'm the one that lead the army of heaven. Are you hearing me? And devil was dilly-dallying. What did Jesus do? He blew open the door and said, surrender. In your life, the enemy will surrender tonight. You will be taken away. He will not do any harm from this night. As long as you believe the Lord and follow, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. If you have been a watchman, has the Lord told you to get away from here because you can't go to heaven from here? Anybody like that? So, what are we talking about? Have you seen any manner of backsliding at our pulpit? I'm asking you. You know, on Sunday, somebody came for counseling and said he was in a church, which you know very well. And then, 2008 or thereabout, God was giving her revelation. He was among the prayer warrior. And said, if you like, pray and die here, I will take you to hellfire. I was looking. He said, God said, all of you that are here praying, church or church or church or church, he said, you will end up in hell. What is the foundation of the church where you find yourself? This Sunday. I mean, Wednesday. Day before yesterday. I said, tell me what. God told you, he said, when he resisted, that God took away joy from her until she went out from the accommodation they gave her and started wandering up and down. And unfortunately for her, she was a watchman. And left the church to another place. And then she ran to her pastor and said, I am ashamed to come back. The pastor said, come back. She wanted to worship in another place, running away. God said, it's not every place that you can get to heaven. Not every place. God is trying to deliver that particular lady. Am I correct? He have made a promise. I will contend with he that contendeth with you. Until she came to Coco. Didn't know it was a watchman. Somebody invited her. I said, come and see watchman here. And then she came in. She felt nobody knew her. But she needed to open up. If you, my brethren, we have worshipped in places. I am not telling you anything about the church. That was what I told the woman that lost her womb. And she got offended. And she died in the process. If not for the God of glory. You stay where you know the foundation. I didn't start saying this thing today. I went to somewhere along Geba Road. And I saw a person that read in Israel. He was a pastor in that place. Have you gone to Geba Road? He was a pastor there. I said, what are you doing here after going to Israel? He said, I'm a pastor here. I said, are you an animal? I'm sorry because he is older than myself, but you know, that day I think I needed to close my eyes to talk to him. He said, what do you mean? I said, how can you be a pastor in a native doctor's house? And then he queried with me. I said, okay, I dey go. Our president will say, me, I dey laugh. But he didn't take time. He started seeking for me until he found me somewhere. And he remained to need that. He held me. He said, I like such men like you. You have saved my life. He said, go and ask questions. If I ever enter there again, from this time I'm telling you, count me out as a human being. He said he didn't know before. The man was a complete native doctor. He didn't inquire. and they thought he was in the place of God. Shall the prey be taken away? Shall he be taken from the hand of the mighty and the lawful captive delivered? No matter the problem in your compound, whether your father shed blood in the ancient past as a warrior and that blood is tracing you, even up to now you are doing funny things and your parents are imagining what is happening, the Lord will set you free. Yeah. Once you are willing, the reason is that God wants revival to start here. I say God wants revival to do what? To start here. If you ask me the reason, I will give you the reason when you meet me personally. That's not the topic of this night. When you stand on the Lord will honor you. He's a very faithful God. The ministry has been standing through thick and thin. Hallelujah. I told them you don't come to charismatic hour. Everywhere will be filled. Outside, inside. And then you come to Bible study, people will be two here, three here. I say, if we reduce one from our number in charismatic hour, then we are not worshiping God. Every Bible study, we must be the same number we were in charismatic hour. And the people understood me. We started going into reading Bible and writing. If you come to Bible study, what happens is that the same number you see in charismatic hour, if you reduce it, will be small. Complete house. You don't go to Bible study. Don't you know it's a problem that you are a prey in the hand of the devil? What, you ask me why? Because you are from a generation that doubts God. Jesus said, this generation of unfaithful people. There are a generation from family, they go to church, but they never believe God. They come in the days of miracle, they don't receive. In the day of Bible study, they don't go at all. When you remember going to church, it's as if your parents are dragging you to church. God will heal you from that sickness this night. David said what? What did he say about going to the church of God? He said, I was glad. After this night, you will become the assistant pastor of your parish. By work. Morning, day, and night, you will be serving the Lord. Because something will happen to you tonight. Yeah. I say something will happen to you tonight. Yeah. Anything you are doing on earth and you keep Jesus by the side, you are into trouble. Are you going to become a medical doctor tomorrow, a lawyer tomorrow? Many lawyers are possessed. Don't be a possessed lawyer so that you don't kill people. Be a child of God. My wife wanted to go for surgery. And I've concluded every arrangement, done every test. And then, I said, it's in my manner. I needed to tell my father, look at your daughter-in-law. Look at what is going to happen. And then, after we have spent money, did everything, he said, you are not going there. No oppression. Even though you have taken time and all these things, I was looking. He said, because it's not every doctor that is in the hand of God. You get to the one that devil is using, they will tell him, kill this woman. This is the wife of a man of God, so that they can cause sorrow in your house. And I folded my hand, I closed my mouth. Until the thing was finished, everything over, I don't know the hospital, I don't know the doctor. It was one day we came for a meeting here that the doctor called me on the phone, and then not even the doctor, the one that our daddy called. I didn't know anything, I didn't go to the hospital. We burden ourselves too much when we run away from God. But if we want to carry our burden, it will be too heavy for us. Assuming I went my way, and I'm a widower now. How do you see it? God forbid. Because I listen to him, my family is intact. And I pray that there is no friend or enemy that will take you away from the Lord. Yeah. In your school, everybody will know you as a child of God. Yeah. The way they know they call people and they shoot them up and down, they will know you. Once anybody is sick, they will knock on your doorpost. Once there is a matter of canceling, they will knock on your doorpost. Yeah. But this night, you must be taken away from the hand of the terrible. No matter how long it has held you. Masturbation in the bedroom where you go to bath, it will stop this night. Yeah. You are up to 15 years old, but once you go to bed, you urinate there. Why? Somebody will come to lead you and say, come and urinate in the toilet. And you follow the person and say, no, let me go inside the bush. And you went inside the bush, and the bush you went into is on your bed. And when they called for this meeting, you were not, you're very willing to come, but you remember, I will marry myself. This night it will stop. Yeah. I said this night it will stop. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Your deliverance will be so easy. Number one thing, you have to receive Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Confession of sin. And say, God, no going back. No going back. Forsake it and denounce it. And say, me, even the friends that lead me there, no more. From today, I live for you. Cancel my name in the book of death. Just write my name today in your book of life. I'm coming there. And you will see joy flush into your heart this night. As you return, I remember the day I came to my two, but I've given my life to Christ. And somebody that was in the choir where I was born again, Rush, woman, held me and was happy. Where do we go to now? And I looked at her. I said, how do you know somebody that have given himself to Christ? She was saying, eh? I said, look at me very well. Something has happened to me. That thing, never. I didn't know her anywhere. I knew her in the church. And some people will be in the church and use the church as a contact point for evil. You'll be in the church and you'll be a child of God. Ask yourself, why am I in the church? Why am I here? Why did God allow me to come to a place like this? Is there not a reason? If there is a reason, has it been fulfilled? That reason will be fulfilled. I said it will be fulfilled. Look at this use. Eh? You are too much to take over Nigeria. How many persons took over Babylon? Was it not 3 persons? Eh? I'm asking you. Praise the Lord. Everybody shout hallelujah. I said you are too much to take over Nigeria. Therefore, Nigeria will be very cheap for us to take over. Let me hear you say amen. Do you have unbelief in you? Do you know the day our daddy came to my parish and then looked at the people and was shouting, look, youths, youths, youths. He was saying, hey, see youths. I was trying to know why he was saying that. When you have a father, you try to know him. Why was he shouting youths? When he left, I called meeting. Servant of God was shouting youths, youths, youths. And then we started saying, why? We discovered that youth, they have strength, they have stamina. When they want to do something, they don't remember wife or husband. Am I correct? I said, okay, we are many here. No more remembering home, food or no food. We are going to take over Lagos. I told them and we started walking. People will come to their house and say, is anything wrong with you? You don't rest again. They will come to church and give testimony that people are asking them whether something is wrong with them. If something has not gone wrong with you, you will not go to heaven. Yes. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. I don't want to reveal something because you are waiting for servant of God to come. We want to give him a surprising package. And you will get to churches, we remain 20, 1,000, 2,000 in the church, and people are jumping up because our hands are tied. Every chain that is tying anybody here, the Lord will burst it asunder. Yeah. Who told you that the places are so difficult? When we are delivered, we can deliver others. Every prayer will be taken this night. And every lawful captive, the Lord will deliver you this night. It must be this night. I said it must be this night. Are you willing? Are you willing?
Yes.
You must confess those things with your mouth. Are you hearing me? Then you repent from those sins. You denounce those, you say, me, no more. Denounce them and separate from it. And then hand yourself over to Jesus. Small prayers this night, eh? Some of you will go for, what do you call it? Night cry after now. You will see the joy of the gospel coming into your life. You see all the dream you have been having where you are ministering and people are coming to watch man running, but you have not realized it. It will start from this night. Hallelujah. I want all those that have stolen one thing or the other. Don't let the person by your side know that you have stolen it. Or shall go to the congregation, let them surrender them one by one. Now, not tomorrow. God is very much in need of you. Before I will say come for prayers, do you want us to close your eyes before you do that? Needless. Hand it over to, do you want to throw it? If you throw it, will it not spoil? That's the point. Don't keep anything. You may not have tomorrow. Don't keep anything. Are you hearing me? Don't keep anything. I've seen something. Please, don't keep anything. I went to minister to one of our brothers in Ijegu, satellite. He sent the father and said, unless he saw me, that he wouldn't want any more thing unless he saw me. We're friendly. And he had been leaving because I used to talk to him. He came to watch man before me. Then I went to him. And I saw that he had no tomorrow. I spoke to him. He told me some things. After telling me that thing, he was calling the father, the mother, everybody come. I'm very happy now. I'm okay. I'm healed. And the father started jumping up that has been healed. I was still on the road and they called me that he has died. He was waiting for me to minister to him. That's Jesus kept him until he said some things. If he didn't say it that time, he would have gone to hell. If armed robbers can drop their gun, you are a child of God. Is it not only handset that you stole? You stole somebody's slippers. Because the slippers look flashy, you put it in your box. You will not go with it so that you don't die with stolen article. God will keep you in Jesus' name. Let's rise up and say a very big amen. Amen. Remember, this is watchman. Are you hearing me? Remember, this is what? Watchman. That as the Lord is doing you good, you will still remain under the Lord. Don't run away so that devil will not destroy you. Don't go on to any ministry you don't know very well. Shout hallelujah. Usher, go round. Even the biro you stole, give it to Usher. Rise up everywhere. Rise up. Release it before we pray. Close your eyes so that you don't see anybody. Even the biro you stole, release it. Close your eyes. Bring it out. If you don't see Usher around you, throw it to the pulpit. Don't mind. There may not be tomorrow. Before we pray any manner of prayers, because those yokes, the Lord will break them this night. You will return home a new person. I am not guessing. You will see what will happen to you. Hallelujah. Usher, go round. Go round. If you feel like getting an usher around you, raise up your hand, the usher will come around. Surrender anything. And maybe tell the usher where you got it from so we can return it. Is that Bible? Continue. Go round. Don't worry. Okay, give to him. Go round. If you have some in the hostel, tell the usher. The one you have in the hostel, where you hid it. Because you are a pastor and you are a prophet and prophetesses. Am I correct? So, you should have a good foundation. Return them, still go round. Signify, raise up your hand, give to them. So that we don't pray prayers and it will condemn you. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty? The Lord is doing the work right now. Yes, return them. But the handset, don't say this handset is very beautiful. Don't say that. It's not good for you. Return it. Or shall move fast? Move fast. So I can pray for them. Shout hallelujah! Something strange will happen to you. I said something strange will happen to you. If you start burning those trousers you are wearing and naked, my sisters, say amen. Say amen. Any day you start burning those trousers and naked, and anybody comes around and say, why? Is it a sin? Don't listen to the person. By the time you finish burning it, you will see what will happen to your members. A lady burnt all her own, who was mocking watchman people. And one day she came, God caught her. She ran home, took all the trousers, everything in her hair, and burnt them. When she finished burning them, she discovered that something was moving in her tummy. And before you know it, from her private part came a live lizard. She is still in our ministry till now. Do you think that a young girl can go naked on the road ordinarily? No. There must be a projection. But the prey must be taken and the lawful captive delivered. You might have gone to Babalawo white garment so you can pass an exam. And still you are failing every day. The Lord will destroy everything. And from this night you will start doing well. I'm still waiting. Okay, those books we are stolen too. Money, how much? Okay. Bring money also. If you stole money, bring them. Anything you use it to buy, bring it out. So then the thief Bible too. If you are the person and you don't have Bible, why not tell us? Tell me I give you Bible. Do quick. God will bless you this night. Somebody say very big amen. As they're bringing it, just wave your hand and let's sing. That rock that never fails. Let me hide in you. Oh, let me hide in you. In you there is power. Sing it now. Bring it out. That rock that never fails. Let me hide in you. Oh, let me hide in you. In you there is power. Give it to the usher. Give the money. The rock that never fails. Let me hide in you. Oh, let me hide in you. In you there is power. Bring it out. Bring it out. I am waiting for you. Bring it out. Bring it out. Music ministers, help me now. Bring it out. You want me to call your name? Bring it out. Amen. Everybody say amen. Amen. Bring out that handset now. Should I leave you to go and bring it from where you hid it? Bring out the handset. Bring them out. Unless if we dismiss, you bring it and give to your leader. Don't go with it at all. Because God wants to do you good. God wants to do you good. You will see what God will do to you and do for you for obeying his word. Are you hearing me? I will give you opportunity to pray prayer of confessions and to receive salvation this night. If you know that you are here and you want to receive Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, lift up your hand. You want to receive him as your personal Lord and Savior? Lift up your hand. Nothing to be ashamed of. Nothing. You can take a step of faith, come in front. Don't bother, just take a step of faith, come in front. You want to receive Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? Come forward, you will never remain the same. Let something be done, brother. How do we get to them? Whether you are coming today for the first time to watch, man, God knows you. You can come out. You may be a watchman without knowing it. Come out. Leader, something must be done. When you all give your life to Christ, Nigeria will bow for the Lord God of Watchman. Praise the Lord. I hope you know that I'm not saying that Watchman is the only church on earth. Am I saying that? No. But I'm telling you, the doctor that saved my life is the doctor who will direct you so that your life will be saved. Am I correct? I won't direct you to any place you will die. I'm not saying this is the only church. No, I've not said so. But this is where I am sure here on earth you will be blessed. And in heaven, you will receive your final salvation. So why run? What do we do? Leaders, they must be ministered to. These are children of God that the Lord is interested in. Okay, I want you to pray now as you are kneeling and standing. Tell God where you are, you know, you all things about you. Tell him. Confess everything and tell him that from today you will follow him. You will see the type of peace that will come into you. All the people in the congregation, stretch out your hand toward them. Or you open your mouth and talk to God. Tell God, confess those things. Pray for them. Tell God. Oh, something great is in this place. Something great is in this place. Something great is in this place. Something great. The people that the Lord will use to dismantle all the errors. Our gathering is not in vain. Pray for them. Confess all those sins. I did it one day. Here am I today.
talk to God. All the immoral lives, no more. Life of stealing, no more. Life of lying, no more. As you return to the hostel, return all the handsets and the slippers you have stolen. Return them. Talk to God. It will do you good. Shall the prey be taken? That small animal that the big animal has caught and there is no escape, can it be taken? Yes, only by the power of the Lord. Only by the power of the Lord. And the lawful captive shall be delivered. In Jesus' name we pray. Say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for this evening. I come before you with all my heart, denouncing every work of Satan in my life. Devil, I reject you and all your works and all your agents. From today, I'm a child of God. Haven't confessed all my sin. Jesus, be my personal Lord and Savior. Cancel my name from the book of death and write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Jesus, for I am your child from today. Do you see that? Lord, I thank you for all of them. I remember the testimony of your servant, how a little lad had another person testifying how he came to the Lord. And he himself gave his life to God and is an instrument in the hand of God. You caused this hilltop encounter. You allowed this program because of these words that are here. That today will be a remarkable day of birth in their life. And they will never forget this day, 19th of August, 2011, when they came out and rejected all the works of darkness. Lord, from this night, may they live for you. May they go about to testify what has happened to them. May they never return back to the enemy. In Jesus' name, rise up. Leaders, please, go, look at me. Everybody, look at me. Come this way. The leader will do something before you return to your seat. Just come briefly. Come this way. Go this way. Do fast. We are waiting for you. I want to pray for you. You will see the hand of God in your life. This way. This way. Go. Just go. Go. I'm waiting for you. There is nothing we can do without you because you are very important. Follow them. Follow them. Follow them. You can be great. You can be great outside God. Never. Never. Hallelujah. Everybody rise up. Let us be waiting for them. Start with put your hand together for Jesus. Rise up everywhere. Put your hand together. Rise up everywhere. Put your hand together for Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus. Put your hands together for Jesus. Take up your Bible. Pick up your Bible. Lift it up. Everybody, stand up, lift it up. Say, this is my sword. This is my weapon of warfare. Are you lifting it up? Yes. With this armor, I will see the downfall of Satan. With this armor, the world will hear about my master. with this armor, I will conquer. With this armor, sickness will go away. Poverty will be sacked. Cancer will be taken away. HIV will be healed. With this armor, impossibility shall become possible. With this armor, the barren shall become a mother. Do you know that I'm going to equip you this night with the weapon of warfare? Do you know that as you are living here this night, you will be a great person? You don't believe it? Do you believe it? Do you believe by your hands that this Nigeria will know about Jesus? Do you know that many people have been disappointed with churches? Am I correct? That only tell stories and make people to laugh in the church. And the people, unbelievers, are looking for the true Christ. With this armor, you will present the true Christ. With this armor, I will prove myself a watchman. You say watchman? Are you not a watchman? Bring down your hands. If you are not a watchman, raise up your hand. Anybody? I'm a watchman. Oh. The only difference is that some of you are in the valley, but I am on the height. How many of you are on the height? Hallelujah. Are they coming back? Let them come back. We are going to pray. You will no longer be at the bottom, at the last. You will start taking the first position. You believe what I'm saying? I say you will start taking the first position. Wait and see. Let them come back. We are waiting for them. People that were not happy with you before, after this encounter, they will be happy with you. You have been asking God, which area are you calling me? Because you are confused. Everything will be clear this night. Quickly. I'm waiting for them. All those people that have been eating in the dream. After eating in the night, you will go and sleep to start eating again. Eating. They want to kill you with food. Poisonous food. This night, I'm going to neutralize the poison in those food. Let them bring more handsets. It's not only this one. I am expecting over 10 handsets. And their cards. Over 10 handsets. Bring it because you are wonderful people. You are wonderful people. God will cause a change in your life one by one. You believe that? Music ministers, speak your this thing, let's sing. I pray for them and go. All over the world, the Spirit. Sing it now. All over the world, as the prophet said it should be. All over the world, there is a mighty revelation of the glory of the Lord. As the water covers the sea. All over the world.
All over the world.
Lift up your hands and sing it.
Is
yes. thank you for all these your children. Lord, I pray any one of them that came in here sick, no matter the manner of sickness, let that sickness be taken away in Jesus' name. If you finish writing, you stand up. We are rounding up. Make sure you write clearly so that the people reading it will understand you. Almighty God, Lord, I thank you. I ask, O Lord, that whatever thing called HIV in this congregation, Lord, I give it 1 hour from now. Let it disappear from their members in Jesus' name. Anyone that is having ulcer or threat of cancer in this congregation, I command healing in Jesus' name. That hotness in your stomach, I command it to cease in Jesus' name. I want to pray for the homosexuals and the lesbians that are in this congregation, yoked by the devil. All eyes closed. All eyes closed. Hands down. God is saying that there are a lot of people that are in that evil program. Homosexuals, lesbianism. I want to pray. Almighty God, everybody stand up. If you are sick, even if you are lame, stand up now, you will stand on your leg. We are in the camp. The fire of God is all over this place. You are still holding that handset in your pocket. Bring it out. Don't move out of this gate. The gate of this rock. Close your eyes. Same sex. There's a particular fellow. You've been crying and saying, God, deliver me from the spirit of homosexual. All eyes close. Close your eyes. If you are that person, if you lift up your hand and wave it now, that thing, that spirit that is causing it will fly out. Okay, I can see one, I can see two, I can see three, I can see four, I can see five, I can see six, I see seven, I can see eight, I can see nine. How are we going to survive if we allow the infiltration of devil in our midst? Brethren, remember that watchman is an instrument of deliverance. Am I correct? Yes. Of those that are possessed and oppressed of the evil one. And if that is true of this place, if it is a vision of watchman, Lord, I thank you. I command that evil spirit that is possessing your sons and daughters, Lord, over 20 of them in this place, and even those that didn't raise up their hand, Lord, I command right now, you dangerous spirit, come out in Jesus' name. Never touch those children again. Get out of their lives in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of masturbation, I command you, fly out of this congregation in Jesus' name. Lord, give them joy of fellowship. Let them take up their ministries so that the ministry will be fulfilled. Let them take up their ministries. Let them take up their ministries. Lord, let them take up their ministries. In the name of Jesus. There are those that are intercessors. As you are praying, your heart will be broken and you are crying. But some things are hindering you. Or shall go round now. God is going to set them free, and the power of intercession, the burden of intercession, brokenness will come upon them. All shall go there, bring them out. No prayer, nothing, bam, bam. Just go there, bring them out. I've seen somebody over there. Check them. There are three right now that the Lord is picking out in this my left hand side. You bring them intercessors. Hearts will be broken. And then they will be. In fact, if witches fly where they are praying, the witches will fall down and die. Go down, go and check them. Go and bring them. Intercessors. A little while they will remember a brother. They will remember a sister. They will remember a woman that is having problems. They will remember those that are childless. Check them all. Check them. Check them and bring them. Check them. Every yoke of devil, every hindrance must be taken away. Check them, intercessors. Take up, take up. I shall watch out over there. There is somebody. A mighty snake is going to move out of your body now. That snake that is causing you to misbehave, that snake will jump out. I shall watch it now. That snake will go out violently. You python spirit, come out now. Come out now. Come out now. In the name of Jesus. Check them. Make sure leaders, you take care of them one by one. Because our daddy wants them to serve God with joy. Say, give me the mountain. This is the mountain that men and women will serve God with joy in truth and the spirit. Check them. The Lord is still working in them. Check them. Check them now. Check them. Check them. Intercessors. Yeah. Check them. Watch it. Watch it over there. Watch it. Watch it now. Watch it now. The Lord is still bringing them. Check them out. Any meeting you are going in the night that is not of God, God will separate you from that meeting. Check them. Check them. Lifting up our holy hands unto the Lord. Not any hand. Intercessors, check them, check them, check them. Anytime you want to serve God and you are firing, that is when devil will come and make you to commit one sin. This night, the devil will fly out of you. He will fly out. He will fly out. Can I hear you say amen now? I shall check them before we progress. Check them. Check them. If the Lord promised from the year 1963 that there will be a place like this, speaking through the voice of a man, his own man, a prophet, nobody can gainsay it. Nobody can stand opposed to it. Nobody can stand and then be able to stand. Nobody. Bring them, bring them. Brethren in watchman, say amen. Amen. After this program, you will return home and devil will not be able to withstand the fire in you. Amen. Check them, bring them. Bring them. When God has spoken, nobody can stop it. Yes. I'm telling you from experience. I reported the challenge we had in Okokota, our daddy. I thought everything was finished. I didn't know that God was planning something great. God is planning something great in your life. Usher, go in so that I can minister. Go in. There is somebody, every time objects will be moving in your body. Objects will be moving. Strange movements in your body. Watch it out. That thing, that arrow that enemy cast upon you, I command it to come out alive in your life. Let it come out alive in your body. If it is maggot that is moving, as you go to urinate, the maggots will come out one by one. Any movement of snake in your body as you lie down this night, or lizard or scorpion, it will come out of your body. Fear not. this night. Check intercessors. Take care of them. We are going to, you know, lead them into Christ so that they can cause trouble anywhere they are. Cause trouble. Cause trouble. Oh yeah. Right now, if you know you are interested to be used by God to cause revival in this place, in this church called Watchman, in this Nigeria, in this world, if you know you want God to use you to cause revival, remarkable revival, lift up your hand. If you are not willing, don't lift up your hand, though. Remarkable revival. Love for money will go out. Love for mundane things that are meaningless will go out. And still God will bless you. Shout hallelujah. You are lifting up your hand because you want the Lord to use you to cause revival? Okay. You know that Elijah did not run. Elisha did not run from serving the Lord. Even though Elijah went away from Jezebel, but he didn't stop the job. You will not run. And none of them did any evil. Elisha followed Elijah throughout. Even when Elijah said stop, he said no. I saw something in you that I've not seen in any man. Am I correct? Well, I knew what man just a short while. But I've known a particular church long and I love the pastor so much. But the day I knew what man, I was going to VG praying for the man of God and that pastor. Until God said, look at where you belong, come over. And here we are. Listen, my brethren, this place, God will use you to cause trouble. I say he will use you to cause trouble in the kingdom of the enemy. Revivalists, raise up your hand. Raise up your hand. Watch it right now. There is a power that will touch your hand. It will go all over your body. Every hindrance gone. Every weakness gone. Every manipulation gone. And then you will discover a strange fire power upon you that will use you from henceforth to do that work. Usher, watch now. Watch now. Revivalists now, watch them now. As I count, watch them now. Watch them as I count. Revivalists. One. Check them as I'm counting now. There will be noise because there will be quake in the kingdom. Usher, go in. Watch it now. Two. Revivalists. Three. Watch them now. Four. Watch them now. Five. Six. Watch it. Seven. Watch it. Eight. Watch it. I heard you very well. What them old devil cannot withstand the authority of the Lord. What they carry them very well. What them. Go in. Nine. Go in. People will see you and they will say, what is happening to you? Some great thing. Go in. Ten. Watch them as I'm counting. Watch them. God wants to use you. Usher, watch now. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. That we are never afraid to testify of the Lord. Hey, shout hallelujah! People with strong faith in our God. Take them, carry them. Ahead. Power in your hand. As you go to the street, miracle will be following you. Usher, take them. Well, let's go around. Let's go around. You will return to the village. They will know that you have returned. Everybody will be saying, I will go to their church. I like your church. Revivalists, or quickly, from the youth. Revivalists. You may be a visitor, it doesn't matter. But God called you here for a purpose. Usher, take them. Revivalist. No compromise. Go round. No compromise. Word them. Hold that very well. I command those spirits that are contrary to the will of God. Let them come out in Jesus' name. Go round. Watch five persons now. Again. Usher, watch. Five persons now. There are five persons. Watch them right now. Watch them. Five for them. Watch them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Watch them. There will be a release. Watch them. Check them immediately. Bring them out. Devil will be put into shame. Bring them out. Bring them out. Everywhere. Why are we living if we cannot serve God? Why are we alive? Why are we looking for money? Why are we wearing clothes? Check them. Bring them out. Revivalists. Revivalists. Amen. I don't know my problem. Everybody listen. I've been trying to avoid it. I don't know my problem. There is a person. This Emeka, every time Emeka. I don't know. I've been trying to avoid it. If you are Emeka, come out. Stand there. I don't know. Oh, shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Are you willing to follow God? I'm asking all of us. Are you sure? Emeka, God will like to use you. There is one Emeka in your midst. Emeka, I'm coming. You want to serve God? You want to use your life to serve God? Say amen. Usher, watch them all. Lift up your hands so that I can release you to go. Lift it up. Say, Jesus, thank you. Usher, go in. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you. My freedom has come. Because I've been taken away from the mighty. Because I've been delivered. Open your eyes. Look at me. Usher, watch them. Now what? Watch them. Usher, watch them. Let me tell you, the Lord is rewriting your history. From today, your parents, your pastors will be making mouth with you. Amen. If I can preach the gospel, if the Lord can give me the grace to preach the gospel, He will give you more grace. Our daddy will say, you know, that he wants to make a sign of the prophet. I want to make a sign that you have been delivered. Say amen. Amen. Before I show the sign, can you put your hands together for Jesus? Put it together for Jesus. Amen. Oh yeah, just lift a song. Open your mouth and sing a song unto the Lord. Sing a song. 1, 2, 3, go. Oh yeah, sing a song. Sing it, sing it. Sing it. Sing it. Sing it loud. 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 Amen. Look at the sign. Once I count one, you remove your hand from the rope of the devil. You remove it and say, I am free. Right hand. I count through two, you remove the left hand and say, I am free. Three, remove the right leg. Four, right leg and left leg. Once you remove, you say, I am free. At demonstration. When I count five, you remove your head from the rope of the devil. You do it the second time. Third time, from here to your family, there will be signs and wonders follow you. Leaders, take note, because we must still have some people to pray for. Take note. Oh yeah, get ready. Are you ready to receive your freedom? Yeah. Pay attention. What is happening to you now is happening in your house. Yeah. It's happening in your village. Yeah. Amen. Yes. Listen, you know, go and tell people that the gospel in Watchman is not come and hear, it is come and see. When you teach a gospel that people will be listening and say, we not get you, we're waiting you talk, your gospel done the baroon. Are you hearing me? I said, when I had Sodom and Gomorrah, see, no. I said, I won't see the person where they talk. Mary and Rebecca, I said, let's go to the tomb. Let's go and behold Jesus. It's always to go and see. And when they came to the tomb, an angel appeared and said, what are you looking for? Can you look for the dead living among the dead? And Mary could not understand. He said, no, you can't see him here. It doesn't belong to the dead again. And then Mary turned and saw Jesus, but did not understand. He said, hey, are you a gardener? Where have you hidden my Lord? And Jesus looked at him and said, so you can't see again. That means your eyes have been covered. Mary, and then her eyes were opened. I said, oh, Rabboni, listen, every covering in your eyes this night, every veil, something that is making you to think that sin is better than living in God, that veil will be torn apart this night. Are you willing to come and see?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Can you sing that song? Okay. One. Yes. That rope has torn. No? Sign of the prophet. Two. Usher, get radio. You think I'm joking? Wait, you will see. Three. Usher, watch. Something will start happening now. Watch. Four. Watch as they're receiving freedom. Watch it. Freedom from marine kingdom. From hardship. From any manner of thing. And you are receiving power. Usher, are you ready? Watch them, watch them, watch them. Every chain. Devil is targeting the youth, but he will not get you. Hold him very well. Hold him. Make sure he doesn't wound himself. Satan is a wicked man. We can never be his friends. Hold him very well. Take him to the other side. Watch his head. Watch his head. Hold him very well. Hold him very well. Somebody should hold his head. Get ready. He remains removing our neck from the rope. David said, instead of the rope tearing my neck, the rope was broken. How many times? One, two, three. You see your freedom. Come and see, wonderful Jesus. Come and see. Then come and see,
wonderful Jesus.
I say, come and see,
oh wonderful Jesus.
What man, come and see,
oh wonderful Jesus.
Come and
oh wonderful Jesus.
Then come and see,
oh wonderful Jesus.
I say, come and see,
oh wonderful Jesus.
I say, come and see,
oh wonderful Jesus.
Come and
oh wonderful Jesus.
Come on,
come on,
come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on neck from the trap of the devil. I shall watch them. You will see. Are you ready now? Are you ready now? Oh yeah, 5, 1, 2, and 3. Usher, watch, go round now. Usher, go round. Stop now, watch it now. Go round. Every rope. Go round. Every rope. Anything you have eaten, any chewing gum, any biscuit, any frustration of devil, any manipulation, every spirit of immorality, I curse it to depart. I curse it to depart. I shall go in. Watch them, watch them. Let the Holy Spirit take over. Let the Holy Spirit take over. Let the Holy Ghost take over. Let the ministration of the power of God come upon you. From today, you will minister the word of God. You will minister it with power. You will minister it with authority. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. The minister has mandated me to pray for the makers. He said there's a particular maker that lived a very horrible life, and you should see us after for counseling. Hallelujah. I want to pray for all the makers. Can you lift up your hands, all the makers? In the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Redeemer, by their names, meaning that God has done so well, God have done great things. Precious Father, do great things, remarkable things in their lives tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, all the iniquities they have committed, forgive them.